It is no cliché that consultants create lots of PowerPoint slides. During my time in consulting at McKinsey, I probably created several thousand pages over the course of 6 years that I was there. But the more experience you get as a consultant, the more you notice that a lot of people outside of consulting, even those working for large multinational corporations, many of them are really not good at creating these PowerPoint slide presentations to meet the level and the expectations of senior leaderships of large companies. So welcome to another coffee break here on my channel, Firm Learning. My name is Heinrich, and on my channel, I want to help you to become successful in the first years of your career. And today we are going indeed to talk about slide presentations. By the way, if you want to know more about creating slide presentations in the style of consulting firms, I have a full online course only dedicated to the topic. I will link it below in the video description, so check it out if you want to learn more about this topic. So let's get going. The insight that I want to share with you today is the importance of avoiding clotheslines. And I already briefly touched on this in another video, but this concept is so important that I really wanted to go a bit more in depth on it. So stick in here with me. I will, of course, add lots of new thoughts to this in this video. So what is a clothesline? As a young consultant who does his or her first slides, this will be a feedback point that you very, very often get, that you really cannot do slides that contain a clothesline. But indeed, outside of consulting, you see slides like that all the time. And indeed, clotheslines are probably slides like this. A clothesline is a list of bullet points. An unstructured list of bullet points. Something like this, where you have thought one, thought two, thought three, four, five, and so on. So you talk about a topic, you create a slide, you write bullet point after bullet point. That is a clothesline. But why is this bad? Well, the problem with this is that this more or less seems to be like a result of your brainstorming. So you're talking about a specific topic and you're just writing down all your thoughts bullet point for bullet point. But are these now all relevant thoughts? Are these all the most important thoughts? Are there maybe more thoughts than that? Maybe there are, maybe there aren't. But for the reader of this, for the recipient of this communication, it's very difficult to get the confidence that the things that you have here on the slide are indeed all the relevant thoughts. And this would be my very first recommendation. So what you should do is you should always come from a structure. Say, when you talk about these topics, there are these two or three main topics that you need to consider. And then in these main topics, then there are these thoughts. So my first recommendation here would be that whenever you have a list of bullets that you want to bring forward for a communication, you should group them. You should cluster them into groups and then also include these groups on the slide to also communicate the structure. Because as soon as you do that, you can say something like, so I looked at this topic and identified three main areas, three main groups, three main clusters to look at. One, two, three. And then within these clusters, then there are the thoughts that you wanted to talk about in the beginning. Now, in terms of going even one step further, what I would recommend you to do in these situations, even to form it a bit more, often something like separator lines like this can help to clean it up a little bit more. But then also let's include a title, because without that, it often looks a bit random. Okay, so there are these groups, there are these thoughts, but what exactly are these thoughts about? What exactly is this that now you are sharing here? So often a simple title like that can help to create clarity of your expressions, of your thoughts that you want to share. So let's just make an example that, for instance, you talk about measures, levers that you propose for your business, for instance, to save cost or to grow the business or to anything else. And now let's title it also this way. Let's title this, for instance, key measures, because if you do that, it also helps your thinking, it helps your writing, that indeed now every single point should be such a key measure and shouldn't be just like a random thought that you had that you wanted to add here. But what I would argue is that if you do it this way, it's still not a perfect slide. It's still a very text-heavy slide. Now you did introduce some groups, but it still seems a little bit dull. And now if you would really fill all of this with text, the slide will likely be very text-heavy. And then maybe indeed still not really making it easy to comprehend the key messages that you want to bring forward here. So what I would recommend you always to do if you do text heavy slides like that, but think in different categories, think in different types of messages that you want to come across and communicate. And often, for instance, when you talk about measures, there will also be other things that you can talk about. Maybe, for instance, you would want to introduce some examples for these measures or some very tangible suggestions of what could happen. Or maybe you have a title of a measure and then another information where you explain this title, explain what this is about. And here, this is always a great opportunity now to divide the slide into different columns, that you don't only have one key text column, but at least a second one. Here in this example, first of all, a description of the measure, but then also always an example. So this often enriches the slide, adds details, again, helps you to provide a structure and helps it to be more easily digested, because now the person knows what the measure is all about, and then also an example how to make this more digestible. So I hope you can really see the difference from going from this, so just an unstructured list of thoughts, to such a structured version with a header, and to maybe even integrating different types of information to enriching the slide in this direction. I can only tell you that this is a technique that is extremely frequently used in consulting when I was at McKinsey, and I trust that all the other consulting firms as well. So I can only encourage you to use it next time you work on such a slide. Now I know that I do have many people who are also very experienced in slide writing in the audience. So let me know please in the comments below in the comment section. Do you agree with that? Do you have any other tips to share? I'd love to hear from you. Of course, as always, if you took any value out of this video at all, I would very much appreciate if you could hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm, turn on the notifications and subscribe to the channel. My name is Heinrich. I release new videos every single Saturday. I now want to say also big thanks to all the members of the channel. Thanks for supporting this work here that I do on From Learning. Very much appreciated. And if you want to continue your learning journey with From Learning, especially also on slide writing, I will link here in the end cards a video where you can continue that with additional content that I have on this topic. See you again next week, and bye bye.